Okay, so in 2012, I decided to play a top tier deck, and many of you are, majority of you are familiar with it. It was Dino Rabbit. It was insanely, like, it was huge, man. It was this, it was like the first deck, pretty much the first deck that utilized vanillas because of this rabbit here. And you pretty much, you would just spend Laggias and Dolkkas and just consistently do that and just, it was really like if you play mirror matches, you really needed to know what to do. Otherwise, like, you just get outplayed because there's a bunch of sequences that you could bait your opponent into doing, into using the login to get prematurely, or if you were unaware that they had the lance to protect it to avoid avoid you forcing it with like a dark hole or something, or I'm pretty sure was there a dark hole? I can't remember. No, I was thinking smashing grounds and stuff. Yeah, I think it was that. But yeah, like it was really technical. Of course, there was those times where you would open broke, and your opponent would open up vanillas, and then that would be just like, okay, that's not fair. Like you really can't do anything. But anyways, the whole reason I picked up that deck, like particularly that one, is because if you look at the Fonton, the original secret rabbit. Let me tell you a story, because this is the whole reason, the methodical reason of why I wanted to play it. Okay, so I went to sneak peek, I wasn't planning on playing it, and then I end up pulling both the exceeds, right, the Laggia and Dolkka, and then I end up pulling the rabbit. I was like, oh, what the hell is that? And then I look at if you look at the code closely, I'll try to do a close up. If you look at the code and you turn it upside down, it says Leo, and that is the only reason I was like, oh, I'm gonna play this deck, because it had some sort of meaning. Like, I'm not sure if I'm being self-centered, but like, the one thing is that me pulling the three, and that saying that on the rabbit, I was like, oh, so I ended up buying it off one of my good friends. This was when I was back home in California. You know, it was just insane, man. And then I ended up taking that deck to Nationals, and it was pretty close. I was made day two as well. But anyways, that's the whole reason why I have this like dearness to that deck next to Synchro, because of that particular reason. And already, as you've seen, I managed to mix up Paleo and Rabbit, because the dinos you can use is Cobblestool and the Megalo, and they're both waters, so they synergize with with Swap. I mean, the only synergize that you would actually need because it's water. But I was like, let me try it. It's actually not that bad. I mean, of course, you see some of the, like, if most of these replays, you see me opening up with vanillas, and that's not ideal. Like, what you would want to do is either open up Rabbit or open up Swap and back row, and then open up a Toad, and then you just generate links with the Totally, and that eventually turns into your Starboy or your Deco Talker, and then that sets you up for future Rabbit top decks, which is really good. Like, Laggia, Dolkka, and Totally, that's pretty insane if you can manage to establish that setup, because it's pretty much negation on top of more back row, which is pretty insane. And Strict Charge, this is hilarious. I think he pretty much charged Heavy Dust Storms me, and I was about to pass and like end phase him and then do my Rabbit play next turn, but he just ended up gunning it, and I'm like, okay, that's fine. So that's pretty cool. I mean, that card is pretty devastating if you have the drone lockboard thing, cause that's, like, you literally can't do anything. So that's pretty bad. But anyways, I quickly wanted to show you guys this build, because I've been working on it since last night. It's pretty basic. There's been just a few minor changes to it. This card is insane. At first, I was trying XYZ Reborn, but I noticed that I think bringing back a dinosaur or bringing back a frog would be much more beneficial, because sometimes you don't have, like, XYZ Reborn requires you to have an exceed. Like, if you open it first turn, it's like it's not live. At least with Back to the Front, you can bring back a frog, which is really good, because you can bring a Swap Frog, Dupe Frog, and there's these insane plays where you can protect a shot with a dupe. Like, there's times where I think you saw in one of the beginning games, I think, where you let a dupe die, and you just bring it back, bring back a paleo, and then they still have to attack the dupe, and that protects you for like a future setup for the following turn, which is really cool. I really like that. And this guy just wrecked me with a bunch of Twin Twister, because most of you know, if you Twin Twister Paleo, they're going to be really devastated. And it was freaking crazy how like this duo ended up turning out to be. I was like, oh my god. There's this one thing I was prepared for pretty much every possible scenario, except that new spell card. What's that called? It's the pill card. The one that's the special freaking a level 7 dinosaur ignoring its summoning conditions. Like, I was not expecting it. And right here, I completely forgot. I thought I had another. I had more material to make another romp. Totally, but I didn't. So that's why I did this. But yeah, that was a complete like a misplay, hard right there. But yeah, like this is just insane. I really like this card in this deck. It just makes up these little cute little neat sequences that are needed sometimes. If you're not playing like the pretty much the demise build, and where you just like make totally burn through your resources and just replenish it with demise, this is more like it's similar. I mean, you could add that if you wanted to, but like if you don't want to, it's, I don't know. It is good, like hands down. Like demise is just demise. Like, it's just a freaking good card. But I feel like I could do without it, so I don't know. But yeah, I've been having fun with this deck because it was pretty cool. Cause, like, totally, and the rabbit. And like, God, it's really crazy. Like, okay, so like, I was trying to prepare for every scenario. Okay, so if he has, the only way I lose if he has the Tyranno, which is like, I can block through one, right? I can do the one if he topples another Tyranno. Conductor. I mean, yeah, the Tyranno guy. I can do with one, but there's no freaking way I could deal with two. That's like way too much. Cause like, I would end up getting something to discard with Totally. Get a frog to use Dino, and then I'll have a book, and then I'll protect myself, and then just do another Toad. Pretty sure. Do another Toad the following turn. I'm like, okay, yeah, I'm covered, I got this. And then he just freaking uses that damn pill. Like, okay, well, I can't, that's it. That's freaking crazy. Hang on, let me quickly show you guys the deck list. Okay, here it is. Okay, so it's pretty straightforward. It's kind of what you expected. I'm pretty sure the majority of you had an idea of how it was going to be. I was playing Maxi, but I don't know. I have no idea why I just don't like Maxi. It's a freaking insanely good card. But I think it's because I'm just so paranoid of just top decking it so much that I'm like, oh my god. So I don't know. But yeah, of course you can put Maxi for your hands down. Like, you can. I might just add it later because it's Max C, but then we kind of have an idea of what the top decks are right now, what people are choosing to play. But I don't know, I seem fine with that. And but that's pretty much it. You play three of the Megalo, three Cabasuls because there's water. It's really cool. And the three Rabbit. Oh my god! And then Solemn Brigade, Solemns, and then the one guy that tells them what to do, and then your basic 9 Paleo, and then I really like Break the Skull. It's a double card, pretty much. Use it on your turn, use it on their turn. Either one. You use it twice. It's really good. I like it. And it's just the fact that you can change to a Paleo. It's really cool. And then your XYZ lineup. You can change this if you want. I wasn't playing this guy at first, but then it comes up so much that I was like, okay, I gotta put it in, so that's good. And 3 Toad always comes up. Dweller, I'm not too sure. Like, again, we don't know exactly what decks are gonna be good, so I'm not sure you can replace that for like Tornado Dragon. That comes up much more, I think. And then Castell, same thing, it's just who knows. And then double Laggia, double Dolkka, because sometimes you don't know which one to go. And the fact that you can bring it back and keep doing it, that it just seems like the right thing to do. And but yeah, like I was trying to XYZ Reborn before this, but there's times where I didn't exceed yet, and this would just be dead. So I just prefer this one. This is much better. It's I don't know, from what I've experienced. And I was trying demise, and I don't know. Like, it's good. If you want to play demise, you can play demise. I was just thinking about keeping it at 40. You can, of course, put more than 40. But yeah, you can add this if you want. Pretty sure many of you will, because why not? They're good. And then I was playing goats as well, but Same thing, I'm not too sure. This is just, I wanted to keep it as basic so I can know what's missing. Like you focus on what you want to do, and then eventually, okay, I'm having issues with this, and you just add and make an addition to it, and then that's how you fix the consistency of even control decks, because it's not the same as a combo deck like Dark Synchro is. Like Dark Synchro is, everything has to flow because every sequence is based upon your entire hand pretty much and your opening hand, whereas these decks, it's much more slow paced. You just pretty much your aim goal, like your goal is to pretty much disrupt your opponent to a point where it leaves them in awkward scenarios, and you capitalize on that with your potential push the following turn, and like that's different playing style. But anyways, it's still good. We like it. And I was gonna play Sword Charge as well, but I don't know, same scenario where establishment, like if you top deck it, if you open it, it's like, oh damn. And then Gamma Seal, just get rid of Masterpiece, because people are still playing Masterpiece, and that's pretty insane. And then I was playing this as well for the goats, because it's, you can just end phase, make a Mrs. Radiant, and then proxy. That's free links right there. That's freaking insane. But a lot of times, whenever I would have it, I would have goats and toad, and then I would like stem a phase special it, and then okay, well that's kind of awkward. And then for whatever reason, they always had Twin Twister, and then just get rid of it, and okay, that doesn't work so well. And I was playing Gofu at first too, but I don't know. Same thing, you have to open it, so I'm not too sure. But this is just like a blueprint of what I'm trying out, because it's pretty cool. But anyways, hopefully you enjoyed the video, and thanks for watching.